We've been telling you about the declining bee population and how that could ultimately impact local fruit farmers. Today, Brianna DiPilato spoke to engineers at RIT about a possible solution to the problem. It involves a high-tech gadget. She joins us now in studio to explain. Brianna?
Well, Brett, we're talking about drones, small drones that would fly around and pollinate flowers, ultimately taking the place of missing bees.
It's becoming more visible. People are starting to realize, you know, that, hey, this is a problem.
The problem is the declining bee population, something beekeeper Ward Graham says he believes stems from impacts from the environment.
With pesticides and climate change right now is really devastating bees.
So could the solution to this problem lie in the form of technology like drones? Engineers at RIT say it's possible. They've already found uses for drones in the agricultural world, helping farmers tend to specific plants without having to treat an entire field of crops.
We can literally look at the plant level and tell if a plant is thirsty, if a plant needs nutrients, or if a plant is sick.
Engineers also say these pollinating drones, if you will, are still a ways off.
These types of drone systems that we're talking about, like the one shown here, are very large in size. For that bee application, obviously you want it to be much, much smaller. Possibly within 5 to 10 years, I can see that happening. But as of today, we're not quite there.
But beekeepers like Graham see these drones as a temporary solution.
One, yes, this is a stopgap to get us past this problem. But two, let's focus on the underlying problem and try to, you know, mitigate that impact.